Hello everyone. My name is Natalia Ivleva. I'm a head of Raman and Scanning Electron Microscopy Group at the Chair of Analytical Chemistry and Water Chemistry, Technical University Munich. And I would like to present you results of MiPAq project achieved by our team, Dr. Elisabeth von der Esch, Professor Martin Elsner, and me. So we will discuss automated analysis of microplastic particles by Raman microspectroscopy. As you may know, microplastics are emerging particulate anthropogenic pollutants and represent very challenging analyte. These particles are characterized by complex nature. We have to consider broad size range from 1 micrometer to 1 millimeter or even up to 5 millimeter if we consider large microplastics. We have different polymer types with various chemical composition, including conventional and bioplastic microplastics. Can have different shapes, spheres, irregular particles, fibers, films, foams. Also various additives and sorbed contaminants can be present. Furthermore, microplastics can be characterized by different aging state. And it has to be underlined that the degree of contamination of the environment, drinking water and food remains unclear, and that analysis of such complex samples may resemble searching for a needle in a haystack. Therefore, it's urgent need to develop reliable methods for the analysis of microplastic particles and fibers, especially in the low micrometer range. This analysis has to include representative sampling, efficient sample preparation, as well as sensitive identification and quantification. In order to establish reliable and representative analysis of microplastics, appropriate reference materials are required. Therefore, we develop a method for simple generation of suspensible secondary microplastic reference particles using ultrasound treatment at alkaline conditions. This method is shown to be suitable for the production of microplastics with different shapes, including irregular fragments, spheres, fibers, and films. Our procedure yields fragments in the broad size range from 100 nanometers to 1 millimeter, thus microplastics and also nanoplastics can be produced. The method is validated for polystyrene, polyethylene terephthalate, and polylactic acid. These reference materials are already suspended during their formation and can be efficiently resuspended in pure molecule water. Furthermore, the particles show infrared spectra comparable to spectra of naturally aged microplastics. Thus, these particles are well suited as reference materials for the method development. Now, let us discuss how automated analysis of microplastic particles and fibers can be realized. We start with the deposition of our samples on the filter. Then all particles and fibers have to be localized. And the number of fragments that need to be measured has to be calculated. At the next step, chemical identification using Raman microspectroscopy can be performed. Finally, we will obtain morphological and chemical information on all measured fragments, including particles and fibers. But how many particles have to be analyzed to guarantee representative analysis of microplastics? To answer this question, we apply a method used for the prediction of election results, namely simple random sampling without replacement. The number of particles which have to be identified depends on the total number of particles on the filter, estimated microplastic content, margin of error, and confidential interval. And even if we have million particles on the filter and plastic fraction of only 1%, it will be sufficient to measure 7,000 of particles to achieve representative results with margin of error of 20%. It is also important how we choose the particles and fiber for the analysis. We can use cake model or SNAIM model, but best performance can be achieved by application of random model. To enable the analysis of thousands of microparticles and fibers automatically, we developed open source software TUM Particle Typer. Our TUM Particle Typer allows for the detection, characterization, and quantification of fragments in different images, for example, fluorescence, scanning electron, or optical microscopy images. The use of adaptive thresholding allows to avoid any human bias. And the identification of microparticles and fibers can be performed by Raman microspectroscopy. Here you can see an output of TUM Particle Typer. We obtain coordinates for Raman measurements. also morphological characteristics of fragments, the area as well as minimal and maximal ferrite diameter are determined, altogether allowed us to perform automated classification of fragments. Thus, automated detection, morphological characterization, identification, and quantification of microplastic, but also non-plastic particles and fiber is possible. At the moment, we can analyze up to 7,000 randomly selected fragments larger than 10 micrometers on the entire filter. And we are working further to develop the representative analysis of particles smaller than 10 micrometers. At the end, it has to be stressed that for the reliable analysis of microplastics, harmonization and standardization of methods is required. Therefore, together with colleagues from many labs around Europe, we summarize minimal requirements and best practice guidelines for the analysis of microplastics with micro-Raman and micro-infrared spectroscopy. The guidelines address precautions to avoid sample contaminations as well as sampling, sample preparation, and analysis. Are you interested in our work and have questions? Please do not hesitate to contact me via email natalia.ivleva@tum.de. Thank you very much for your attention.